What's up, guys? It's Evan and Harrison from the Wildlife Brothers, and today we're on location in southern Maryland taking a look at an incredible raptor species, the Western Osprey. There are more ospreys here than anywhere else in the world, so we're super excited to get out into the environment and take an up-close look at this amazing species of bird. Now, right behind me is our target species for this trip here in Maryland, the Western Osprey. This is a species of raptor that can be found all over the world, and in fact, ospreys are found on every continent except Antarctica. Now, here in North America, Western ospreys can be found across southern Canada and down through every coast of the United States, both on the East Coast, the West Coast, and across the South. These guys inhabit any body of water that's large enough to support their prey. So that's going to include habitats like lakes, rivers, marshes, and especially estuaries, like down here in the Chesapeake. Now, one of the amazing things about this particular region is that the Chesapeake Bay is home to the largest single population of ospreys anywhere in the world. The population density here is absolutely insane. And on a day of exploring like this, Evan and I can come across anywhere from 20 to 30 unique individuals, and we will have dozens of encounters throughout the day. So we are super excited to get out and see how many ospreys we can find and tell you a bit about this amazing species of hawk. Ospreys are a piscivorous or fish-eating species, and in fact, up to 99% of their diet is comprised of fish. Now, in the Chesapeake Bay, they'll be eating things like menhaden, shad, and mullet, though throughout their range, their diet will vary depending on which species of fish are local. And ospreys are perfectly adapted for fish hunting. They have what's called a zygodactyl foot structure, which means they have two talons in the front and two in the back. This gives them an incredibly firm hold on their prey and stops them from dropping fish while in mid-flight. Now, what these guys will do is hover above the surface of the water, scanning for any fish that are exposed, and when they spot their prey, they'll dive down and grab them right off the surface of the water. What's amazing is that ospreys can spot prey from anywhere from 10 to 40 meters in the air. They have incredibly acute eyesight, and that makes them very powerful predators. In fact, these guys are the apex predators here in the Chesapeake Bay ecosystem, and it's incredible to witness their natural behavior out here in the wild. Ospreys are very large raptors, and they reach about half a meter in height and have a wingspan of 2 meters. They're incredibly large and powerful predators out here, and to accommodate, their nests are quite large as well. They can reach up to 135 kilograms in weight and are constructed of reeds and twigs collected from the salt marsh environment. And it's actually not uncommon to see osprey nests built on human structures such as pylons and channel markers. Ospreys nest from late spring to early summer, and they'll raise 2 to 4 chicks on average. Now, ospreys are monogamous, which means they mate for life, and in fact, they can live about 10 to 15 years in the wild. Now, when we were here in Maryland last season, we actually had the opportunity to film at an osprey nest. We got to see both the mother and the chicks, which is an incredibly rare opportunity to actually witness the interaction between a mother osprey and her young. The osprey is a perfect example of a species that was brought back from the brink of extinction. Now, in the 1960s and early 1970s, the populations of ospreys here in the Chesapeake Bay were incredibly low, and in fact, there were fewer than 1,500 breeding pairs left in the region. That is due primarily to the use of a pesticide called DDT. Now, DDT did not cause the death of adult individuals. What it did is it caused the eggs of many different raptor species to become incredibly brittle, to the point where almost every egg laid was completely inviable. That means that the populations of species like bald eagles and ospreys plummeted across the United States. Now, luckily, in 1972, the use of DDT was banned after the effect that it was having on the ecosystem was realized, and that allowed for the populations of ospreys across the country to make a huge resurgence. Today, there are over 10,000 breeding pairs of ospreys here in the Chesapeake Bay, which makes up about 20,000 individuals. That accounts for a full fifth of the osprey populations that can be found in the world, which number around 100,000 individuals. This is incredibly important for the health of the Chesapeake Bay ecosystem. As we've mentioned, ospreys are an apex predator, and they keep all of the other trophic levels below them in line. So if your apex predator is doing well, that means that the populations of things like fish, invertebrates, everything below them is going to be kept well in check, which keeps the ecosystem running the way it should. Filming ospreys has been a goal of ours for a very long time, so we're really happy that we finally got this episode completed down here in Maryland.
Definitely, we've been trying this episode for a number of years, and for one reason or another, it's never come together, but finally, it came together in a great way.
Definitely. So if you guys enjoyed this video, make sure to leave a like on it, and tell us in the comments down below if you have ever seen an osprey while you've been out in the wild.
And don't forget to subscribe to the Wildlife Brothers now. We have a ton more content from all over the map coming very soon, so we'll see you guys in the next episode.
Oh, that's nice.